We will discuss about the transportation of spermatozoa in the female genital tract. So after ejaculation, at the time of copulation, the spermatozoa, they have to travel through the female genital tract. So what are the factors that facilitate the transportation of spermatozoa in the female genital tract? So the contractility of the female genital tract, which is under the influence of neural reflexes and hormonal activity, that facilitate the transportation of spermatozoa, as well as the kinocilia and the ciliary cells facilitate the sperm transportation. So this cilia also plays very significant role for the transportation of spermatozoa. The cells, the lining cell of the female genital tract, some of the cell in the, especially in the oviduct, they have ciliary cell. And some of the cells, they have kinocilia, and then these cilia, they facilitate the transportation of spermatozoa in the female genital tract. So while traveling the spermatozoa in the female genital tract, they have to encounter different luminous fluid of different physicochemical characteristics. So these are the fluids secreted in the different parts of the female genital tract, and they have different component. The spermatozoa, while they are traveling, they have to encounter. And there is phagocytosis in the uterus or other part of the female genital tract. So because spermatozoa is the foreign body. So the spermatozoa, while traveling in the female genital tract, they have to encounter fluid and the phagocytosis activity. And those medium cause the physiochemical changes in the spermatozoa, and that is called capacitation of the spermatozoa. So capacitation spermatozoa, it is ability of the spermatozoa to fertilize the egg. So in this topic, we will discuss here the site of ejaculation, transportation in the female genital tract, and the spermatozoa transportation in the uterus, oviduct, and hormone related for the transportation of spermatozoa in the female genital tract. Then summary and references. Let us see the site of ejaculation. Different domestic animal, the site of deposition or ejaculation varies. Like cattle, sheep, monkey, rabbit, generally they ejaculate. Site of ejaculation is the vagina. Horse, dog, pig is the uterus. So how the spermatozoa move in the female genital tract? How the spermatozoa are transported? So this spermatozoa are transported, and it is divided into three stages. They are transported in the female genital tract in three stages: rapid transportation, and sperm reservoir, and slow release and transportation. So let us see the rapid transportation. Rapid transportation, some of the spermatozoa can transport it rapidly to the oviduct from the site of ejaculation, and it can reach to the or enter the oviduct within a few minutes, 2 to 10 minutes. But whether that first sperm entering the oviduct take part in fertilization is not known, because there is a minimum number of spermatozoa are required for fertilization at the site of fertilization. Then sperm reservoir. In the female genital tract, there are some reservoirs or establishment of some reservoir, and that reservoir play a very significant role. The reservoir also helps the sperm to protect from a hostile environment in the female genital tract. So more sperm enter the reservoir and more reaches to the oviduct. So if there is more sperm entered in the reservoir, and there are chances that more sperm can reach to the oviduct. And when the more sperm reach to the oviduct, the chances of successful fertilization is more. So reservoir also play a very significant role to keep the sperm and release slowly. So if they are able to keep more sperm, they can release the sperm, more sperm to the ovator, and the chances of fertilization is more. Larger reservoir, the longer an adequate population of spermatozoa is maintained. If the reservoir is large, they can accommodate more numbers of spermatozoa, and that release of spermatozoa or the population of spermatozoa, more numbers of spermatozoa is maintained. So what are the reservoir? First we will see the cervical crypts. Micelles of cervical mucus direct the sperm to the crypts, cervical crypts. So this is cervix, and these are the cervical crypts, the fold like structure. So after ejaculation in the vagina, and the sperm is rapidly moved to the cervix, and the cervix have the option that this spermatozoa can enter to the cervical crypts, and these are act as a reservoir, and these are called cervical crypts or sperm reservoir. And from these reservoirs, our sperms are released slowly to the uterus or the site of fertilization. So these reservoirs play a very important role. It protect the spermatozoa from hostile environment in the vagina. Vagina, the site of ejaculation, is not suitable for a spermatozoa. So when the sperm ejaculated, they will quickly or rapidly transport it to the cervix. So the sperm, if it remain in the vagina, there is phagocytosis and the sperm become immovable. So this reservoir protect the sperm and keep the sperm and release slowly. So cervical secretion, it has fewer leukocytes, so there is fewer phagocytosis as compared to vagina and uterus. So vagina and uterus is not very suitable or good environment for the spermatozoa. And it enhances the survivability of spermatozoa in the female genital tract, these cervical crypts. It protects the hostile environment of vagina and from phagocytosis. It might provide environment for the capacitation of spermatozoa. So this reservoir also thought to play or help the sperm to undergo capacitation. So the reservoir, we have seen in sperm reservoir, we have seen here cervical crypts. And other reservoirs, utero-tubal junction. So suppose this is uterine horn or uterus, then uterine horn. And from uterine horn, we have the oviduct. And this junction, uterine horn and oviduct, this junction is called utero-tubal junction. So while as spermatozoa, they reach to this side, this area also provide a reservoir for spermatozoa. And from here, the sperms are released slowly to the site of fertilization. So this junction is called utero tubal junction. The reservoir is utero tubal junction. And in the uterus, there are some endocrine gland. These are the, so while traveling the spermatozoa, while traveling the spermatozoa in the uterus, this spermatozoa can enter to the endometrial glands in the uterus. But this from this area, there is no evidence that a sperm can release from this area. This endometrial gland, the sperm may enter to this area in the uterus, but this sperm are destroyed in this area. They cannot, no, there is no evidence for the release of a spermatozoa from this area. So a massive number of spermatozoa can enter and loss in the uterus. So these are the reservoir, sperm reservoir. We have seen cervical crypts and utero tubal junction. Then slow release and transportation. Slow release, when the spermatozoa are in the reservoir, this spermatozoa are released slowly from the reservoir. So the motility of the spermatozoa They are released slowly, and the motility of the spermatozoa as well as contractile activity of the myometrium facilitate the movement of spermatozoa to the site of fertilization. So spermatozoa have to encounter different products, secretory product of the female genital tract, and that make them capable of fertilization, capacitation of spermatozoa. So slow release, when the sperms are reserved in the entered in the reservoir, and from the reservoir they are released slowly to the site of fertilization. So this is about the three stages of sperm transportation in the female genital tract. Let us see what are the events occur while traveling the spermatozoa in the uterus. So massive numbers of sperm may invade the endometrial gland in the uterus, and those sperms are lost because there is no evidence of release of spermatozoa from endometrial glands. So presence of sperm induces phagocytosis. So presence of sperm in the uterus, it induces phagocytosis. There is inflammatory responses, infiltration of leukocyte, and there is phagocytosis. So spermophagy, spermatozoa taken into phagocytic vacuoles and digested by the macrophages. That is called spermophagy. Agglutination of spermatozoa in the uterus. So sperm is sticking together at head to head, or at the head or tail, or head to head attachment. They are unable to move, or this sperm cannot swim. Sperm. So this is sperm. They are head to head sticking to each other, and this is sperm. This is called agglutination of sperm, and this sperm cannot move or cannot swim. That is agglutination of sperm. So we'll see in the oviduct how, what are the factors it facilitate sperm transportation. So oviduct, it transport the sperm and egg in opposite direction, almost simultaneously. So peristalsis and antiperistalsis of the oviductal musculature facilitate the sperm transportation. So the contraction of the oviductal mucosal fold is a complex. So ciliary action in the oviductal cell. Pigeon and tortoise, there are two systems of kinocilia found in the oviduct. One beats toward the ovary and other toward the cloaca. So oviductal contraction and ciliary movements are controlled by ovarian hormones, adrenergic and non-adrenergic activity. The pattern and amplitude varies in different segments of the oviduct. So these are the factors that helps in the sperm transportation. Then hormones. So estrogen, it primes the uterus for oxytocin. So during the time of coital stimulation or during the time of copulation, the sensory neurons are stimulated in the cervix, and because of that stimulation, there is release of oxytocin, and that oxytocin cause myometrial contractility. So that also facilitate the sperm transportation. So this is oxytocin helps in myometrial contractility, as well as the semen also contain prostaglandin that also facilitate the myometrial contraction. So when we summarize the sperm transportation, sperm have to travel from the male genital tract to the female genital tract. Sperms are produced in the testis. These sperms have to travel through epididymis, and they have then vas deferens, and sperms are, and it is the secretory product of accessory glands are added, and the semen which is ejaculated at the site of ejaculation, that is vagina. So this sperm as well as the fluid secreted by the accessory gland. So in the female genital tract, this spermatozoa are the cervical crypts, they keep the spermatozoa, and slowly they release from this area their reservoir. And from reservoir, after releasing from the reservoir, they have to encounter with endometrial fluid and endometrial gland. Some of the spermatozoa are lost in the endometrial gland or the fold of the endometrium. Then the sperms which are successfully able to move from the endometrium, their uterotubal junction provide a reservoir for them, and they, from this area they are released slowly to the site of fertilization. So this is what happened, and the sperm have to encounter and protect it, or they have to undergo or encounter different fluids and different components that make them the ability to fertilize. That is called capacitation of a spermatozoa, which occurs in the female genital tract. So this is about the transportation of a spermatozoa in the female genital tract. The references. So this is about transportation of a spermatozoa in the female genital tract, facilitated by the myometrial contraction and the ciliary movement. And the capacitation of the spermatozoa also occurs in the female genital tract. Thank you.